Hello friends. In this review, we will look at a compact Zigbee sensor from the Tuya Smart ecosystem, which measures air temperature and relative humidity. In addition to sending this data to the smart home system, the device, thanks to its display, also allows for visual monitoring. We will also check compatibility with various smart home management systems, first using a Zigbee gateway with Matter protocol support, then with alternative Zigbee coordinators. You will learn how to receive data from the sensor not only in the basic Tuya Smart system, but also in Apple HomeKit, Google Home, Home Assistant, and Sonoff iHost. Before we start, as usual, I ask you to like this video. It will help other people interested in smart home topics find it. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet. The device type, temperature and humidity sensor with a display. Interface, Zigbee 3.0. Recommended operating parameters. Temperature, from -9.9 to 60 degrees Celsius. Humidity, from 0 to 95%. Power supply, 2 AAA batteries. Size, 51 by 51 by 16.5 millimeters. Ecosystem, Tuya Smart, Smart Life. The device comes in a small cardboard box with a photo of the device and the interface indication, Zigbee in my case, but there is also a Wi-Fi version. On the back side, as usual, the main parameters are listed, which I have already mentioned. In addition, there are a couple of illustrations that replace the manual, about resetting the device using a paperclip, and that the control app can be downloaded via the QR code on one of the box's side panels. The package includes only the sensor and accessories. There is no paper manual. It can be downloaded via another QR code link on the box. Inside the box, besides the sensor, there is a paperclip for resetting and switching to pairing mode and a small piece of double-sided tape. Batteries are not included, so you need to prepare your own. As I mentioned, the sensor is very compact. It looked bigger in the photos. The device size is 51 x 51 x 16.5 millimeters. The screen is square with rounded corners, measuring 28 by 28 millimeters. Above it is the activity LED. On the backside is the battery compartment cover, to which the included double-sided tape is meant to be attached for wall mounting. Besides the compartment for 2 AAA batteries, under the cover, there is a hole with a button, which requires the included paperclip. A short press checks the connection and forces a data update, while a long press resets and switches the sensor to pairing mode. For a better understanding of the size, here is the sensor next to a standard matchbox, quite comparable with some Zigbee sensors without a display. After installing the batteries for the first time, the sensor automatically enters pairing mode, indicated by the blinking LED above the screen. Let's move on to connecting the device. We will start with the native control system, Tuya Smart. I will be using a Zigbee Thread gateway with Matter support. You can find a link to its review in the description under the video. It is also connected as a Matter bridge to Apple HomeKit, Google Home, and Home Assistant. After starting the search for new devices on the gateway, you need to make sure the LED on the sensor is blinking, meaning it is in pairing mode. There were no connection issues. Everything worked correctly and quickly. The plugin is standard for this class of devices. The main screen displays the current air parameters. Below that is the change history in graph form, which, as you use it, will be available by day, month, and year. There is a settings and scenarios button. The settings include battery level data, temperature scale setting, Celsius or Fahrenheit, and notifications for high temperature or low battery. The smart button opens the sensor automation menu. In the general settings menu, it's the standard set. Compatibility with third-party systems, sharing, home screen placement, firmware version check, and removal from the system. In automations, the sensor is intended for use as a trigger in the if section. Here I found an interesting option. The trigger can be a change of temperature scale. It's hard to imagine a real use for this. The other options are logical and useful for use in a smart home system. These are temperature, humidity, and battery level values, which can be greater than, less than, or equal to a set value. By the way, the sensor was also found in the action section, then, Here you can forcibly change the temperature scale, although, as with the similar trigger, it's difficult to come up with a practical application. As I already mentioned, the gateway is connected as a Matter bridge to several smart home management systems. Let's check if this sensor will work in them. Let's start with HomeKit. I go to the Home Settings, the Hubs and Bridges section. Here I select the Mose gateway, to which the sensor is connected, and I remind you the link to its review is in the video description. Then I go to the Accessories section. And the sensor was found here, showing that it has two sensors, temperature and humidity values. If you enter the sensor menu, at the very beginning, you can see these parameters. I did not find the battery level here. In the climate menu, its values are used along with other similar sensors in this room. Their average values are displayed on the home screen. It's convenient here to compare readings, as all these devices are in the same room. The review subject, labeled as Tuya, a Zigbee sensor from Xiaomi, and an Apple HomePod Mini. Both sensors were placed very close, and the speaker was a bit farther. As for temperature, everything more or less matched, with the data from the sensors rounded to whole numbers here. But regarding humidity, Tuya and Apple show 5 to 6% lower than Xiaomi. And here, I would trust the HomePod readings more. This is Google Home, to which this gateway is also connected. It's the same. There is data on current temperature and humidity values, but no battery level. However, considering that all the previously shown systems work simultaneously, the level can be checked in the Tuya Smart app. This is the Google Nest screen, where you can see the current temperature readings and humidity. Also, to get information, you can use the voice assistant. And the third system to which this gateway is connected is Home Assistant. The standard Matter integration is used. Thus, the data from the devices of this gateway are simultaneously available and can be used in all the systems I just mentioned, provided they support Matter, of course. As we have already found out, the sensor is supported, and Home Assistant is no exception. Moreover, in addition to temperature and humidity, the battery charge level is also displayed here. I'll also remind you that Matter is a local protocol. It works quickly and without delays. Now it's time to disconnect the sensor from the gateway. It will naturally disappear from all the systems just mentioned, and check how it will work with other Zigbee coordinators. Let's start with the smart home controller Sonoff iHost. The firmware version at the time of testing is 2.5.1. I switch the sensor to pairing mode and start device discovery on the controller. The addition was quick, and judging by the fact that an image corresponding to the type of sensor appeared, there were no problems. This is how the device tile looks in the general list. The letter E in the top right corner means it's an end device. Here you also see the battery charge icon and the current temperature and humidity readings. A small life hack. In such sensors, the battery charge level updates with a fairly large delay, up to a day. This is normal, as the sensor consumes very little, and there's no point in sending data more frequently. After connection, the charge percentage often displays as unknown. You can either wait for it to update, or briefly press the pairing button, in this case using the paperclip. This checks the connection with the coordinator and updates all data, including the battery level. This works in different systems with different devices. As you use it, a history of changes will accumulate, displayed as graphs. For viewing, you can set different time ranges. There is a data export function. On the general information page, you can find current signal strength, as well as the device ID, manufacturer, and model code. From here, you can also delete the device, which I'll soon do to check its operation with other systems. In automations, the sensor can only be used in the if section, as a trigger or condition that will determine the start of actions described in the then section. Here you can set the temperature and humidity values at which the automation will trigger. You can choose the option greater than or equal to, or less than or equal to the specified value. Let's return to Home Assistant, but now we'll use not the Matter gateway, but alternative Zigbee coordinators. Let's start with the standard ZHA integration, which works with the SkyConnect USB Zigbee stick. The connection process is standard. the sensor successfully completes the interview and appears in the system. Here you can already see that several entities have appeared. That's a good sign. There's temperature, humidity, a firmware check option, which is non-functional, and battery charge level. In other words, all the key parameters necessary for operation. Just in case, I'll show again how to disable and used entities. We go into it. In this case, it's the firmware check. Click on the gear icon. This is the settings menu. And we disable this entity. Now it won't be displayed, and extra entities won't clutter the system, which is especially relevant in cases where the entire history is written to the database or telemetry algorithms are used. I did a separate series of lessons about that. This is how the device card looks after disabling the unnecessary entity. Only what's necessary and nothing extra. And finally, Zigbee 2 MQTT, an add-on for working with Zigbee devices. Here I'm using a network coordinator based on the CC2652P module, with the current version at the time of testing being 2.3.0. Here, too, there were no connection issues. The sensor was identified and connected normally, and no external converters were needed. It was assigned an image from a round temperature and humidity sensor. Such sensors also exist in the Tuya ecosystem. About 5 years ago, I reviewed a similar one, the Blitzwolf BW-IS4. Two of these sensors are still used in my smart home system. In addition to temperature, humidity, and battery charge level, here there is also the battery voltage value and signal quality level. In Home Assistant, where the device was added via the MQTT integration, besides these entities, the firmware version check was also added. You already know how to disable unnecessary entities. Now another check. The sensor is currently in the room. Humidity level 36.4%, temperature 22 degrees Celsius. As a timestamp, we'll use the change of the entity in the journal column on the right, 33 seconds ago. I take the sensor out to the balcony. As seen from the log, 5 minutes have passed. Since it's colder on the balcony, during this time the humidity reading dropped to 31.3% and the temperature to 20.6 degrees Celsius. After 10 minutes, the humidity hardly changed. It had already reached its actual value, but the temperature dropped by more than a degree, down to 19.4. So the sensor reacts quite promptly to sharp changes. After that, I returned the sensor to the room and left it overnight. The balcony door remained open, so the temperature dropped noticeably compared to the evening. But now I'm interested in the change history. Temperature. On the left of the graph, you can see the dip. That's when the sensor was on the balcony. Then I brought it back into the room, where the temperature rose and then gradually decreased overnight and in the morning. The graph is quite smooth, without the steps typical of devices that rarely send data. A similar graph for humidity, a dip on the left, then a return, gradual decrease, and then an increase by morning. I find this quite acceptable for use in a home automation system. This sensor impressed me. It's neat, not bulky, with a fairly large display. It uses common AAA batteries. You can use rechargeable ones. Compatible with all the tested systems, both via Matter and when connected through alternative coordinators. In terms of readings, it's close to the Apple HomePod Mini. The data transmission frequency is sufficient for use in climate automations, and it reacts quickly to sharp changes in temperature and humidity. Reasonable price. No obvious drawbacks at the moment. That's all for now. I hope the video was useful and interesting to you. I'd appreciate your likes. They help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the description under the video, I will leave links to all the mentioned resources, as well as to my Telegram channels and social networks, and groups for discussing smart home topics. Join us, it'll be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to everyone.